Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Backdrop control. Using the .NET MAUI Backdrop, you can create a layered navigation experience that can display multiple levels of navigation at once, making it easy for users to navigate through your app's content. In this video, I will show you how to add the backdrop control to a .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to add back and front layer content, header configuration, and corner and reveal height customizations. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will show you how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI backdrop into this application. First, I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI backdrop package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native Vue API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the app.xaml CS file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then, I import the Syncfusion MAUI backdrop namespace. The backdrop control provides a full screen interface for displaying and interacting with a single piece of content, just like the content page. So, I initialize the control by replacing the content page with the SF backdrop page tag. First, I'm going to add the primary content by including the backdrop page front layer property. And define the backdrop front layer. Here I can add any content such as menus, tabs, pages, and so on. And now, I add the grid layout. And set the background color property to white smoke. Now it's time to add the backdrop back layer. To do that, I add the backdrop page back layer property. And define the backdrop back layer. To display list options, I add the grid layout and then specify the row definitions. Then I include the list view control. And to provide the list items, add the item's source property. I define the string array with values like appetizers, soups, and so on. I add the background color property to the list view and set its value to Alice Blue. Since I have changed the content page to the backdrop page, I also need to change the base class name used in the XAML CS page. So, I open the main XAML CS page and add the Syncfusion MAUI backdrop namespace and replace the content page class with the SF backdrop page class. Now I press the F5 key to run this application. See, the default backdrop page is rendered with the front layer. When I click on this down arrow icon, the back layer will be revealed. Clicking on the up arrow icon will close it. The back layer can also be revealed by touch interaction, swipe, or fling actions. You can also change the default title of the page. To do that, I add the title property and set its value to menu. And now, the title is set to menu. By default, the down arrow icon is used to open and the up arrow icon to close the backdrop page when it's placed on the flyout page. If you want to change this flyout page to a navigation page, open the app XAML CS page. Change this app shell with the navigation page. And pass the main page as its root element. The backdrop page is now displayed on the navigation page. By default, the hamburger icon is used to open, and the close icon is used to close the backdrop page when it's placed on the navigation page. If you want to customize the default icons in the backdrop page, set the open icon image source and close icon image source properties in the SF backdrop page. You can choose to provide any of the inputs shown here. I'm going to use the settings image from the resource folder to open and tick image to close. Check now, open and close icons are changed according to my input. If you want to reveal the back layer upon initial loading, simply enable the isBackLayerRevealed property. As you can see, upon refreshing the application, the back layer is displayed after loading. I will now disable this feature to explain the upcoming customizations. Next, I will show you built-in reveal height options. By default, the front layer moves downward to display the entire height of the page. This is the fill option. To change it, I add the back layer reveal option property and set its value to auto. See now, the front layer moves downwards to the height of the back layer content. Finally, I will show you how to customize the top corners of the front layer. By default, the top corners are curved. To have a flat corner, I add the edge shape property to the front layer and set its value to flat. And now, the front layer's top corners are flat. To know about the different customization options, check the documentation link provided in the description below. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion MAUI backdrop control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use all our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.